Jimo, Ishak, Slick, Ayomide, Taiwo, Peter, Ofurum, Chika, Ibeku, Chubike, Anams, Ifoma, Abugu, Christian, Onuigbo, Emmanuel, Igbo, Victor, Madoamago, Chidi, Odinawa, Stephen, Agbaim, Tony, Uruama, Tiamu Kazim, Musab Samani, Kolade Johnson, Onovo Matthew, Chinedu Ani, Precious Odua, Richard Gora, Chijoke Iloanya, Linda Igwetu, Daniel Teller, Harry Ataria, Johnson Nemeka, Femi Bello, Chima Ikunado, God's Gift Ekirete, Gabriel Owoicho, Tina Ezekwe, Tony Zita, Modebayo Awosika, Daniel Adewuyi, Chukwuemeka Matthew, Chika Ibeku, Azuamak Madoego, Rinji Bala Uzil, Joseph Edonoji Ugbeni, Anita Akapsen, Chibuke Daniel Ikaguchi, Ifeanyi Ozo, Chinedu Meniru, Augustina Arebu, Anthony Wokike, Paulinus Ogbonna, Ikenna Isaac Megbe, Emeka Ojinze, Ademola Mushud, Ismaila Anyila, Miracle, Sunday and Joy Ndubuize. These are the names of young Nigerians we know. We don't meet their untimely end for the hands of SARS. Sabi Nation, this na how na siam.
Wasted, and we don't want it to be your choice. And for people who forget, I will always say to them, yesterday's victims were once survivors, today's victims were yesterday's survivors, and tomorrow's victims will be today's survivors. The question is, who is next? The victim card is going round, and I tell you today, to be a victim in Nigeria is no longer a matter of if, it's a matter of when. And if you think it will not be your turn, guess what? The last person also thought the same way. The person who died once said, God forbid. God will not do us what he has given us the capacity for us to do for ourselves. We have to come out, we have to make demand. We have to let the government know that indeed their power comes from the people. And on this SARS matter, we are saying no retreat, no surrender.
Fighting so that this land can be better.
They talk about
end SARS. Yeah, that's the key into what they're talking about. You must reform the police.
That's right.
These people will not be animals now. Go see barracks the way barracks they, the way they treat policemen like dogs. That must stop. Now, because they do this thing, they dehumanize the police. I mean, the police, they dehumanize the citizens.
Yeah, that's right.
Now, we must realize two things here. What are the two things? The people in government are there to serve the people, either as public servant, mark the word, or civil servant. They are servants. To us, they are not our rulers. So the ignorance and aggrandizement, the attitude and our problems they've created in the society, it's going to stop. What I see now is a sign that there is a better future for this country, ultimately for Africa as a whole. Because if Nigeria can take this step, hey, I release me that.
Now you heard.
Babe, they go agree.
Because
the
system
must change the right way around. Governance? Not be all these who will get legislators and executives. We need people who will represent the people properly. 2013, they go hear Bogani. The young ones don't come, now not be we again. We don't sit and sit, they fight us, beat us, do everything. Okay, yeah. Oh, yeah. It is peaceful now. No fights. Nothing. See, I cannot deceive you. It make me laugh. I hear one police, they talk, say, we just realize, say, they fight for us. Before we come, now they fight for sins. Not be for ourselves. Your duty is to be our megad, our staff. Now we, they pay now. So you must learn how to guard us. Not kill us or bleed us. You say you carry SARS when they kill people, Abi? Oh yeah, now people they kill us since for Sambisa Forest. Carry them go there. Then they go kill SARS.
My people, for how on Asia, I won't add my too for this end source matter. See, the thing be saying, this end source matter, first of all, I want to commend the youth, the current generation. You know, they're not saddled with our colonial mentality and dog eat dog, and they have the tools to actually, you know, at least spark some kind of conversation. Half a lot talk, half a lot say suffering and smiling. Nigeria, if we not feel end suffer, at least make we end this smiling. And so I see them all. You know, the thing will need more structure, because as you see, and so they don't end the SARS, replace them with, not be SWAT, and they replace them. I don't know which one even come bad pass. The thing be say, sometimes we change, make we day very careful for the change, because these people, they be Maradona. But anyway, Sha, it's very, now something we be saying, a pleasant, welcome, you know, development. At least it's a start. I go say, make we, you know, put more structure. Make we, you know, make sure say we stay on the fight. Stop the smiling. They go listen eventually. Because not only this land that we get, not only this one Nigeria. And if we won't decide to stay together, we go need to fight more. You need to fight for what you love. Sometimes the fighting will be necessary. But all in all, I commend them, support them, but want to make sure say the violence, you know, whatever comes out of it is manage violence. Make it not be seen at all for one, and make we not return back to our dog eat dog mentality. At the end of the day, it still comes down to a power dynamic. The power dynamic with our responsibility, where we get for Nigeria, then we need to solve. Because everybody in Nigeria seems to be waiting to get power to actually oppress somebody. Beyond our leaders, I'm talking about every one of us. So if we can fix that power dynamics and understand, say, even with power, and no human nature to quest for power, but even with that power, responsibility to actually better yourself, your community, and people around you. Not be say one man will go build mansion, road not there to pass. People they suffer all around and go day in house, think say na mansion na in day. All these things that we talk about is beyond end source, but not good start. And so I see them all. And I do look, keep up the good work, my guys. All right, peace.
Right now, how to speak, Ruben. I expect the president to start with to address this nation by 7 p.m. specifically on this issue. Two, in that address, give a directive to the Inspector General of Police to keep all policemen off the streets. Order whether the road safety or whatever and so on to provide necessary security to the protesters on the streets. There should be no shooting of anybody whatsoever. I'm talking of things that should start immediately, not something that will start next week. We are on it. Immediately. Pay visits. Government officials should visit all victims, visit their families, and commiserate with them. In that same speech, the president should immediately announce that all burial expenses, hospital bills, and so on will be bared by the government. Announce a huge ransom, not as compensation, because you can't compensate for life, but to help the family, to sustain them, to help them keep life going. It could be any amount, 30 million, 40 million, 50 million, to each of these families. Let these protesters see action. Not people sitting in offices and discussing under air condition. Let them see the IG visiting homes and saying, "We are sorry, man," to their parents. Let the people see humanity in you. These are some of the steps that we should begin to take immediately. why this is ongoing. You are now appealing to the boys or to these young kids, our children on the streets. Please stay off the streets. We understand your pains. We have heard you. We are ready to correct. We have failed you. We are ready to put things in order. That is how it should be.
Okay, so, Mazi.
Ah, Femo.
What do we don't learn for these protests so far?
Femo, one thing I go talk say we don't learn from this protest. Nah, or what don't learn? If I use that one. Now the way we will take come together, that unity.
Yeah.
Because I just see say everybody they fight for one thing. So yeah. Nobody look your tribe, your religion, or your political affiliation. Everybody just come together as one, say we want change.
Yeah, I mean the Nigerian youth don't tire now. The things where the leaders they take divide the country. Yeah. Nobody they look down on now because yeah. The cause, the thing where they fight for, it affect everybody, irrespective of where you come from or
true.
Or your religion. So
true.
that one, in fact, that one even foster more unity among the youth of Nigerians.
Of course, yeah. Of course. I dey happy say. But we don't wait, make it happen since it don't start.
Yeah.
You know, and would they pray, make the movement continue? Because not be just answers with the matter.
Mm-hmm.
You know, other things they, you know.
Yeah, no, this not the beginning of the conversation.
Yeah.
This not the beginning of the whole, like it, as you call them, just a movement right now.
Yeah.
So not
yeah,
just,
movement.
Not be just protest now. It don't turn to movement. And
yeah.
And the big mistake where the leaders of the country don't make, we say, they don't raise generation we really not depend on government for anything.
Because, exactly.
For instance, light, that they provide light for themselves. This generation don't provide everything for themselves without the government.
Absolutely.
So, absolutely. Yeah, so it just make them easy, you know, for them to fit, you know, continue the whole conversation as they don't start them, so yeah. You know, yeah,
yeah. And if you look the matter now, the besides say we fight for a better part of, you know, let me say better part, better thing for our country, for ourselves and for our country. Now these same police people now we fight for,
true.
Take a look at their salary. I didn't look there for one of those documents where you sent, give me 42,000 naira,
yeah,
for police. Yeah. Salary, average policeman, one wife, two children. How much be school fees? How much be rent? Then food. Then all the other small things you did for corner. How 42,000 naira? How that policeman want to manage that 42,000 naira?
Accommodation too.
Accommodation.
Yeah.
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 Even if now one room, now him and the family they want to stay. You know how much be one room? For the way things be now for that country.
You go pay school fees, you go chop.
Exactly.
You go transport instead of go work.
Exactly.
I even hear say that they pay for their uniform by themselves. Like you go buy your own uniform. I hope not they buy their gun by themselves.
I go buy bullets.
Yeah, exactly. And with all the things where these people they go through, you give them gun to protect people. What do you think that I go take the gun to?
Exactly. Yeah. See their training, for example.
Mm-hmm.
I watch one video for police training. The guy sit down for ground. They carry stick, they knock him for head. Take your hand off. I come to look at it and say, this is not training.
Yes, nah.
Okay. Why did they knock and stick for it? Make it for feet, do waiting. Use the head, break coconut.
Yes. They won't make the head strong now, so that if bullets they come, the guy if he head the bullet, go. Head the bullet, go back.
Go head bullet.
Yeah, nah. nah, train. No, but really, they need to train our police. But the thing is, apart from, I mean, yes, the protest, the conversation now don't start with NSAS, but you see, waiting they happen for the police force, now the general picture of what thing they happen for the whole country, all the sectors. You understand?
I agree.
Yeah, look, education, power.
Yes.
For Christ's sake, electricity, you know, energy. Look, the all the sectors. You understand? Yeah. So this is not just the beginning. Look, in fact, there's so many things we be say this whole protest go kind of move into. You understand?
Yeah.
So now from the message where most of the protesters, especially those blessed Nigerian youths with the on top Twitter, the movement now they go House of Rep and their senators, their salaries and all those things, you know.
Yeah.
Bro, where the police where they come in contact with, you know, where we say they come in contact with the citizens, you know.
Yes.
All those police officers, the ones where they see for street, the one where you go when you go police station and all
the constables.
All those constable and all those people, the ones where they meet, because I know say I don't think say I don't ever meet a police IG or even police DSP or a superintendent and all those ones. You understand? Like you talked before, the highest way you don't meet personally na DPO. Where you go meet if you go police station. But so
down a manager for police station.
Exactly. So these police officers will be say they come in contact with, you know, us, you know, the regular people. This one, not them, their salary be peanuts.
Exactly.
You understand?
Very sad.
They say most of these police were there for streets. Like one of the clips we will play earlier. Most of these police were there for streets. They give them targets to go collect money come.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Even Oga of police self is in on it. Yeah. Allegedly. You understand? As what day for street. And these are people ABC don't get direct contact with police, like one of the guys will be say he do where ABC he record the conversation.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
You know, so it's just not just very crazy situation. And I believe say with this movement, so the Nigerian youth, you know, feel pushing forward to fix other things where they happen for, you know, for the country.
Yeah. You don't hit the nail on every area. Not be something where we go just stretch too much. You understand? We know the world they watch, they see what they happen. It's not just about the police or the armed forces. It's about everything. Now everything. You understand? Total transformation of the country. Where they create jobs, where they, you know, put money for education.
Mm-hmm.
You know, basic amenities. We don't they ask for much.
No.
For more, we know they ask for much. We just want a little comfortable, make we feed our families, you know?
Exactly. And live in peace.
Protect ourselves. Mm-hmm. And the people they protect us, they are human beings. You don't see the police barracks.
Oh.
Shame they catch me. My skin, they crawl anytime I watch that video. You understand? So, I won't make we... the protesters... I commend all of them with the street for more.
Yeah.
You know, all our Hauna Siam people, you know, with the streets, where they join the protest. And everybody.
And our Sabi Nation, where they give us feedback steady throughout the protest and everything. We appreciate. Yes. And the thing is so nice where we say the way the protest, the way they organize the protest, I should say the leaders and all the leaders and all those politicians, they shake right now.
Because of
the way these people organize. You understand?
Of course.
They raise money. They raise money for protest.
Yes.
They raise money. They use one platform, you know. They use one platform to raise money.
Yeah.
And why did they raise the money? I think they block that platform. Yeah. These people enter Bitcoin.
Yes, straight up.
And they raise millions. So most of those protests be like block party. They give people food. They hire doctors in case person faint. They hire bodyguards. They hire
For protection
in case thugs won't take over. Thugs won't hijack the protest.
Yeah.
They, the, in fact, you see the video I sent you, the big kick.
Yeah, the big kick. Wait, they bring lawyers.
They bring lawyers.
People with police arrest.
Exactly.
That's, you know, well organized.
You know, say, when all the leaders, especially from the top, the Oga at the top, we say Nigerian youth lazy. They don't show them the laziness now. Say yes, we lazy, but can you just imagine the way they take organize this thing? So yeah, we praise those young people, those young Nigerians who take their time to organize this protest. They make them peaceful. They send their message, like they send the message, say yes, this is what we want and this is how we want it, and we want it now. We hope say the leaders they listen, and we hope say they go make some positive change going forward.
Yeah, so now to with the hope for. So Sabi Nation, I don't hear him. We don't come give a little bit small talk on the whole NSAS protest will they go on for our country. Until we come on our way again next week, we're gonna stay safe.